morning, judges. My name is Eldon, and this is Brian, Shannon, and Eugene, and we are from Compassvale Secondary School. Our project is to investigate on the efficacy of home-based extraction methods for common herbs as antimicrobial agents. The project looks at the efficacy of three widely suggested home-based methods or using common herbs as antimicrobial agents. The three methods are infusion method, pulverization method, and salicylate extraction method. And the three herbs we use are basil leaves, rosemary, and thyme. We use material commonly found on our phone in this research. Mobile phones are constantly in close contact with the human body and thus posing a threat to the spread of pathogenic bacteria. Questions we want to answer are, which method will yield the best results that correspond to the amount of effort needed to prepare this, and will this study result in the creation of a homemade antimicrobial product? I will now pass the time to Shannon, who will bring us through the investigative approach of our project.
Antiseptic techniques were used to prevent the contamination of bacteria not within our limits. The work area was wiped with 70% ethanol, and before managing any reagents, we wore masks and sterilized gloves. Also, an air circulation was produced by turning on a Bunsen burner, preventing contaminants from entering the work area. To obtain bacteria culture from our phones, we wore sterilized gloves and touched three mobile phones. The bacteria was transferred to the agar growth medium by gently rubbing our hands on the agar dish. The agar dish is then placed into an incubator. We isolated one colony of bacteria and placed it into a sterilized test tube containing 8 cubic centimeters of liquid LB growth medium before placing it back into the incubator. To prepare the herb extract using the infusion method, 1.5 grams of thyme, rosemary, and basil were placed separately into 50 milliliters of boiling water. The beaker was sealed with paraffin before allowing them to sit for 2 hours. After that, the mixture is decanted and the solution is kept for the later part of the experiment. To prepare the herb extract using the pulverization method, 8 grams of each type of herb was grounded into paste separately. The paste of each herb is then placed into a cloth sieve and squeezed over a beaker to extract the herb concentrate. To prepare the herb extract using the salicylate extraction method, our lab technician helped us with the setup. Then we placed herbs in the thimble and used water as the solvent. We then heat the setup and collected the oil extract. To test the efficacy of extract using this diffusion method, there are two parts. Part A, 2 discs of filter paper was settled into solution acquired from each of the three methods. Part B, a filter paper dipped in each of the extract is set on an agar dish spread with 2 ml of liquid growth medium inoculated with Staphylococcus epidermidis and then repeated for Staphylococcus aureus. Now I pass the time over to Eugene, who will bring you through the findings and analysis of this project.
Figure 1 shows the picture of bacterial culture we obtained. There are two common types of bacteria found on the LB agar plate. Staphylococcus epidermidis, which is pale yellow, and Staphylococcus aureus, which is dark yellow. Figure 2 shows the effect of herb extract from diffusion method on the identified bacteria. The herb extract obtained from this method is ineffective as the bacteria covered the entire part of the LB agar plate. Figure 3 shows the effect of herb extract from pulverization method on identified bacteria. For this method, results were similar to that of infusion method where all the herbs extract were ineffective. Figure 4 shows the effects of herb extract from salicylate extraction method on identified bacteria. In this method used, only the basil herb extract worked as there was a clear zone around the filter paper soaked in it. Clear zones indicate the inability of bacteria to thrive due to the presence of effective antimicrobial agents. Overall, rosemary and thyme herb extract weren't effective when extracted in any of these three methods used, while basil herb extract is only effective when extracted using the salicylate extraction method. Now, I'll pass my time over to Brian, who will talk about the conclusion.
With this, our study has revealed and proven that only the salicylate extraction method is effective against microbes commonly found on phones. Furthermore, this study has also shown that not all types of herbs are effective against microbes, as only basil gave us the desired results. With this information, individuals will be better informed of the low level of efficacy of herbs as an antimicrobial agent using the other two methods which were previously agreed on many and will not waste valuable time and effort using them. Now that all extracts obtained from basil using the salicylate extraction method has been proven effective, home owners can consider to incorporate basil oil in soaps, wet wipes, or hand sprays. This product may be more suitable for people with sensitive skin and is cost effective as basil can be easily grown in Singapore. Moreover, this will also really reduce the reliance on chemical antimicrobial agents which may be harmful to the environment. And without further ado, I conclude our presentation. Thank you.